Good morning, children. Welcome back to your English grammar classes. So, children, today we are going to start with letter writing. So, what do you mean by letter writing? You all know letter is a very important means. Why? To keep in touch, in constant touch with your family, friends, and relatives. So, it is a means to keep in touch. If your friend, if your relative, if any of your family members is residing outside, then you can keep in touch by writing a letter. But now we hardly write letter to someone. But in olden days, when people didn't have any phone, any means to contact, to communicate with our friends, what the people used to do? The people used to send letters, and keeping that letter, we can read it again and again. So it keeps a constant touch. It feels that somebody is there to remind, to helps you to remember them. So for that reason, people write, exchange letters to know the health, to know the situation, what is happening, what's going on in their life. So children, letters are of two kinds. We have formal letter and informal letter. So letter are of two kinds, formal letter and informal letter. Formal letter means where we send application or to any organization, business organization, or we invite someone, invitation to official, to executives or to editors of Times of India or Indian Express. So formal letter means where we have any business officials, applications are there, and then you write some to the editor of newspaper or to police inspector, or you have to invite them. If you have to invite some important VIPs, some very important people of gazetted officer, so we send an invitation. So these all letters come under formal letter. And informal letter is written to family members, to relatives, cousins. Okay, so keep in mind, children, there are two kinds of letter writing, formal letters and informal letter. So children, now first we start with informal letter. So children, as we begin with informal letter, we have two informal letter for your semester. So I'll be explaining you the format, how to write format of informal letter. So in informal letter, you'll always start the letter by writing your own address. Okay children, you will write the writer's address. If I am writing a letter, I will write my address. If you are writing the letter, you will mention your address. Is that clear? And see children, in this letter, you have to keep one thing in mind. No punctuations required. Some have the habit of after writing anything, they put comma, comma, comma. So that is not required. No need to put any kind of punctuation mark. Just write the address, and once you write the address, you leave one line. You leave one line, and then you will write the date. The day on which you are writing the letter, you will write the date. And how are you going to write the date, children? If today is 1st August, so 1st, then you are going to write August, then 2021. This is the formation of how to write the date. You are not going to write the date in this manner. This is wrong. This is the wrong formation. You are going to write 1st August. You have to mention the name of the month. You are not going to put the date 8. You are going to mention the write the full name of the month and the year. Is that clear? And after you write the date, then comes the salutation. Well, now what do you mean by salutation? Dear so and so, dear uncle, dear auntie, dear sister, dear friend. If you're writing it to your friend, you can mention their name. okay? And if you are writing to someone whom you are addressing, for example, sister, brother, mother, that first letter would be capital. Now, common nouns won't be written in capital, but here, as we are addressing to a particular person, for that reason, we are writing this using capital letter. Is that clear? So, again, I repeat, first you will write the address, your writer's address. You leave one line. I have put a cross so that to understand that you have to leave one line. Without leaving any line, it will become congested. So, you leave one line, then you will write the date. So, how are you going to write the date? I have written over here. Followed by the salutation. Dear so and so, usko kehte salutation. Again, you will leave one line. Then, see children, you have to write from the margin. If this is the margin, you no need to leave space from the margin. Not required. Okay? So, directly near from the margin, you can start so and so. So, this comes the body of the letter. What you are writing, the content is the body of the letter. Is that clear? So, whatever, how are you? I hope you all are fine. How was your exam? So and so. So, that comes the content, the body of the letter. And then we have the subscription. Then comes the subscription. Subscription means yours loving friend, yours truly, your dear, whatever, yours faithfully, those are known as subscription. And then after the subscription, you have the signature. Signature means not the signature, sign. Signature means you have to write your name. So, in the last, in the end, you will write your name. So, this is the format of informal letter. Once again, I repeat children, you will start with address. Then you will leave one line. You will write the date. Date, the day you are writing. If I have written 1st August, that doesn't mean the day you are writing the letter, you put first this same date. No, I'll cut the marks for that. You have to write the date on which you are writing that letter, that particular letter. Then again, you will leave one line. Then you'll write the salutation. This is known as salutation. Dear so and so, to whomsoever you are addressing. Then leave one line, the content, the body of the letter. And then again, when the letter is over, you have finished everything, leave one line, then comes the subscription. Yours truly, yours loving friend, your sister, your friend, whatever. And then you'll write your name, that is called as signature. So, this is the format of an informal letter. So, now I'll explain you two informal letter. So, children, let's begin with informal letter 1. Write a letter to your uncle giving thanks for a gift. So, you have to thank your uncle for a gift that he has sent. So, first you are going to write your address, children. For that reason, I have not written my address because you may copy the same as it is. So, I have kept it blank. Why? Because you are going to write your address. Then you will mention the date, the day on which you are writing the letter. Then comes the salutation, dear uncle. See, I have not put any punctuation mark. Dear uncle, I received your gift and letter yesterday on my birthday. So, I received your gift. I was delighted with the watch you have sent me. I always wanted a digital watch and this one is perfect. So, uncle had sent a watch for you and you are very happy. You are very happy to see that watch. I want to thank you sincerely and I shall pray that you have a lot of fun and success in your new job. Do come and stay with us when you get a leave. My parents send you their love and best regards. Your loving niece or nephew. Bhanja or Bhanji. Niece and nephew means Bhanja Bhanji. So, if you are a niece, you will write niece. If you are a nephew, you will write nephew. Okay, children, and then you will write your name. You have to mention your name. So, this is this letter clear to everyone? Okay. Now moving on to the next informal letter. So children, we begin with informal letter 2. Write a letter to your sister who has shifted to Mumbai to take up a new job. So your sister has currently shifted to Mumbai for a new job. So for that you have to write a letter. So again, informal letter, you will write your address, then you will write the date, then followed by the salutation, dear sister. Trust this letter finds you in the best of health. So I hope this letter, when it reaches, I hope you are fine and in best of health. Hope you have settled down in Mumbai and you find your accommodation comfortable. I am glad you got a nice place near your office. It will make your travel time less and it will be less tiresome. That means I hope you have found a new job near your office itself. Ghar office ke paas hi mila hai. So, and it will be less tiresome. So, it will also consume your time as well as you won't be tired traveling. How was your new job? I am sure you must be doing really well. I am interested in knowing more about it. Mom, Dad and I are missing you very much. Or you can write missing you badly. They have conveyed their regards and best wishes to you. Do take care of your health and keep in constant touch. Your loving sister or brother. If you are a girl, you'll write sister. If you are a boy, you'll write brother. You'll write your name. So, is this clear? Is this letter understood, children? Okay. So, children, your homework for today is you have to write the letters which I explained you in this video in your composition notebook. In your composition notebook. So the letter which I have explained you in this video, I am going to send the PDF along with this video. So you have to copy those letter in your notebook. So till then, all of you, bye. Take care. God bless you.